This is the last notebook we are going to run together. I leave you the chances to run also the Mooring, the notebook dedicated to how to read and plot the data coming from moorings, and the ones that focus on how to read and plot the data coming from the thermosalinograph instrument on board of a vessel. So this is up to you to run both of them. I highly recommend it. They are very illustrative and quite friendly. I'm going to focus in this one, in the profiler, because the profiler is a little bit complex platform, although it doesn't have to look like a complex platform at all. I say it is complex compared with the mooring and the thermosalinograph. But you will see, it's a very easy concept. So, to start with something, what I say here is that I'm going to skip the part where I download the data coming from a profiler. I have done so already, and it's available in the data files PF folder that you can go and check to see the files that are available. The tip I provide here is that for downloading this kind of files, you just have to set in the notebook number 2 that you want to only download the files whose data type is a PF. PF stands for profilers, as you already know. So this is a briefing introduction, and this means that we are going to skip the download part and go directly to the part where we actually open one of the downloaded files. So let's load the packages we are going to use and keep on going. Here I have put a video that explains how this kind of platform works. In a few words, what we are dealing with is with vertical profiles of temperature and salinity that has been measured by this profiler. The profiler platform is a platform that basically drifts in the water column of some for a certain amount of time, and every now and then goes up and down in the water column. Is then when it makes the measurement of the salinity and the temperature. And I say salinity and temperature because they are the traditional parameters measured by this kind of platforms. But you can now find more and more Argo profilers that are providing also, for example, biogeochemical measurements. But in this case, we are going to see a profiler that is only reporting temperature and salinity. Please just click this video because it gives you a more comprehensive explanation about the Argo program and the Argo profilers. So now we are going to see the files that are available within the data files PF folder. Here you have the full list of the one I downloaded and put there. And we are going to select just one of these to open and read. In this case, this one. Okay, if you want to choose another one, just change this part. And here we are going to actually read the file. As you can see, we have many different information, but the one we really are interested in is in the data variables. In the data variables, you have the parameters observed. This is the values of, for example, temperature and salinity that we already expected to find. Both of them varies in time and depth. So this means that there will be a value of temperature and salinity in a specific time and in a specific depth. This is a profile, a vertical profile of temperature and salinity. When you see adjusted parameter, it is highly recommended to use them instead of the original measurement because it's a delayed mode variable. So it has already been assessed by a scientific, as a scientist. So please use this one instead of the original temperature. We are going to do so later. From this one, from this list, if we want to have a look to something more in detail, well, first, sorry, you have also the attributes of the file. So here you have a lot of more information. For example, the platform name that had provided the data. You have also, for example, the geospatial bounding box, the time coverage, the PA name. And you have many metadata information of the file. So just visit it and be curious and check it because you have a lot of information here. As I was saying, well, if you want to get the plain list of variables that you can eventually check, here you have the full set, okay? And here it is the one we are going to focus on, the temperature adjusted. So let's define it here and start with reading it. One important thing is to have an overview about the parameter itself and check, for example, the unit. In this case, it's degrees Celsius. So this is for you to be aware that we will be working with this unit. And you have also some other information like the node name and the standard name. And we are going to start now with the creating an animation of the profiler track. Okay, as I told you, it is drifting in a specific depth over time. Okay, only going up and down every now and then, but in the meantime, it is drifting in a specific depth within the water column. So this is what we are trying to see here, this drifting. Okay. So the first thing we have to do is to get the lat long pairs of this drifting to be able to see the trajectory. But before selecting the lat long pairs, we have first to check the quality flags of the position. As I told you, the quality flags are the flags that we provide to the values of certain variables to let you know if you can trust this value or not. If the quality flag of the value is, for example, 4, it's bad data, so you cannot trust it, and it's better if you skip it. And if you want to be sure to work only with data flagged as good, we recommend you to filter the variable you are going to check taking into account the quality flag. Only considering the quality flag that equals to 1. Okay, only the values was the quality flag equals to 1. So we are going to check what is the quality flag of the position for this profiler, and also the quality flags for the time, which are the dimension, as we saw before, of the file. So here we have completely clean flag types for the position QC. So there is no other flag but flag 1 for the positions, for the lat long position. So we are good to go. We are not going to need to make any filtering. This is the same case as the time dimension. We are good to go because everything is flagged as 1. Nevertheless, I have put here how to filter by quality flag. So in here, the way to read it is that we want the latitudes valued where the position QC QC is flagged as 1. This way we only preserve the latitude values that are flagged as 1. That means that are certainly good data. We do the same with the longitude and with the time. This is what we are doing here, basically. And next, what we are going to do is build a profiler geometry, which is going to be just a GeoJSON shape with a feature, which is going to be a line string, and we will populate this coordinate with the land of pairs that we have created here, defined here, and we will populate this with the times that we have defined here. So let's run this cell and this one, and let's populate with this latitude, longitude, and times this GeoJSON. This is what we are doing here. And let's plot the resulting feature, the resulting trajectory. And play, click play. So here what we are doing is animating the trajectory of the profiler. This is how the profiler has been moving around the Black Sea since it was first deployed. It was deployed here, and it will end up somewhere else. I'm going to just accelerate this so that we don't have to wait for it to finish. But this is all the way that it has done. It has basically more or less completely covered the Black Sea, and it ended up here. It started moving from here, and it ended up here. This was the trajectory of the profiler, and along this trajectory it has been making profiles. Every now and then it has going up and down within the water column, making the measurement of temperature and salinity. So this is what we are going to plot next. We wanted to know first where it was moving, and now we want to really see the data, and this is what we are doing here. First we are to select only one profile. Okay, so for example, we are going to select the first profile that was performed here. Okay, for doing this, we just select an index for the time. I have clicked here instead of here. And we set a title saying that it's going to be the first profile, and we check the first profile. This is a profile, actually. It's just how the temperature varies over the depth. So from top to bottom, we can see how the temperature is getting colder. Okay, as you move from the surface, which is warmer than the bottom of the water column, this is the profile of the temperature. And it's the typical profile. And this is only for the first, profile performed here. Okay? But we have many of them. Let's plot all of them, for example, plot. And no matter the location of this profile. So what we are seeing here is each single profile ever taken during the platform lifespan. Okay, so since the beginning to the end, we can even distinguish the different seasons. Probably this is around summer, this is again around summer, and this is again around summer. It has been like 3 years working. So 3 summers in here, 3 summers, which are the moment where the surface water is warmer. Okay, and this is just a quick comment. You can probably see many different things happening. So like turbulence. Here we are seeing how in winters the water gets more turbulent because of the wind and the storm and everything, so that the temperature along the water column gets homogenized. Okay, there is no this straight separation between the surface water and the bottom water. Well, probably some expert in this data can say a lot more. Okay, but this is just an example. And then we are going to do to create the 3D plot. Okay, the 3D plot is where we are going to see the actual profiles as the profiler move. Okay, this is done in the next test. In here we are setting just the color map. In here we are telling how many profiles we want to plot. In this case we are choosing all of them. Okay, if you don't want to choose all of them, just set here a different number. You can set here, for example, 3. So you will only plot the profiles number 0, 1, and 2. Okay, and well, we are going to leave it for plotting all of them. But if you want to make a subset, a particular subset, here is where you have to do it. Okay, so we are going to plot the 437 profiles that during the 3 years this platform has performed, and let's check it. It's indeed a very nice plot, like this one. You can see here the actual move. We already saw this shape when checking the overall motion of the platform, as you can see, like a new. And we can see it here again, like a new. And the different profiles from top to bottom of temperature, that's the instrument has been performed. Okay? So it's quite illustrative. This figure is it illustrates pretty well how a profile works. Okay? And that's all. I hope you have find this interesting, and that you will be able to run the Murin and the Thermosal notebooks. Please, you know already where to find me. If you remember, I show you in the notebook number 1 where to locate me within the Copernicus Institutac website. And there you have my email, and please feel free to reach me for asking me any question regarding the notebooks. During, we will have a dedicated session in the brief session of this training, but you can also reach me afterwards or whenever you need, okay? So don't hesitate in doing it. And thank you for joining, and sorry for this many information, and I hope you find it everything profitable for your needs. And thank you again. The book.